Good morning, everybody. It's a little later than I usually make videos. It's like 10:30, but I had homework to do this morning, so this one's coming late. But also, no tea today. New mug, courtesy of my grandmother. I do not endorse anything this man does, but this mug is actually really fucking hilarious. Yeah. Shout out the Goofy Trump mug, I guess. I don't know if you can read it, but it's just like, it's like a joke. It's like, what does it say? You're a really, really great 21-year-old, the best, terrific, fantastic. Everyone else is a loser. It's just goofy, but it's funny. There's Mary Lou's in this. Shout out, ooh, Mary Lou's would be a sick sponsorship. They like only exist in Massachusetts, but like if Mary Lou's could hook me up with like, you know, sending K cups and shit my way, that'd be crazy. So yeah, Mary Lou's, hit me up. Hit my line, please. But anyways, today's video, I'm doing kind of like a redux on a video I did almost 7 months ago. 7 weeks ago. It was called like a message to my professor, and it was for our behavior mod project. Where basically I was like, okay, for this project, like I want to improve everything. But I think the biggest thing I wanted to improve on was like self-defense and self-confidence. It was very emotionally driven after recent events. And obviously, a bunch of shit has happened since then. My video production has declined. My mental health was not that great. Slowly, it's coming back up. It's getting like really good now. I've had a really good week so far. You know, I'm doing all the right habits. I'm getting back into it. Staying present, staying mindful, you know, not really fucking around this time, which is good. And it feels awesome. But I think the biggest thing that I learned from this project and that I would like to kind of convey in this video is just that, like, how do I say this? I'm not invincible. As much as I would like to be, I am not. And I have learned this over the last couple weeks, and I've learned that a lot of my coping mechanisms for anxiety and depression involve, you know, physical activity. And it got so bad to the point where I was like just literally running myself into the ground. It wasn't just running, but like, you know, at the peak of this, I was playing hockey, lifting, running, like hockey once a week, lifting 5, 6 times a week, running probably every day, you know, walking, hiking, like a bunch of other stuff that I don't account for that I just do just because I need to be outside. But like all of that, and then on top of that, you know, trying to take MMA classes, like I was bound to get injured at some point. And as I've kind of like eased back from the concussion, I've tried to, you know, get back full swing into things, and I'm realizing that it's too much. Like there is a balance somewhere where I can pick up other hobbies and implement those that aren't gonna injure me. I say that one of the things that I've been starting to do again is cooking. I have injured myself before cooking. I was when I used to work in the kitchen, we had like this big bag of like shredded cheese. And I sliced open the top of the bag and like, I don't think I have a scar. It wasn't that bad. Like it could have been so much worse. I didn't hit my wrist or anything, but like I think I like sliced open like my fingertip, and my boss was like, "Oh my God!" Like I was like, "Oh my God, I got blood in the cheese." He's like, "Who fucking cares? Jesus! Like, are you?" I'm like, "Yeah, I'm fine." But yeah, like cooking. I've gotten a lot back into meditating. I'm doing consistently. Writing. I finally finished. For those who haven't read, I can't speak. Anthropocene Reviewed by John Green. I did my own kind of review of a song, but like how the song has affected my human experience, because that's kind of like what the book is about. So yeah, I wrote one of those and got back into that. Consistently make these, work more on, you know, this side of things, because it's just gotten to the point where, you know, my way of coping was, you know, meditation occasionally, but like it definitely went down a lot after spring break. It was literally, it would be eating or working out. And you know, I have a bad history with eating, so I was like, this needs to end immediately. So working out, I was like, okay, I love working out, it's awesome. I cannot consistently work out at this rate anymore, or I'm going to injure myself again. And if I injure myself more, then, you know, it's gonna be a lot worse than the concussion. You know, if I tear an ACL or something, I'm done for like 6 months of doing anything. So trying to reform and find new hobbies and stuff to do in the meantime that will not injure myself, but are also like constructive. So like not drinking, not, you know, spending a ton of time playing video games or watching TV, which I really don't. Limiting the time on my phone, you know, just all of that. So yeah, basically just trying to get back into that sphere. Also, it's really nice out, so that helps too, like just being able to go outside. But yeah, this is just my little Redux video for Dr. Schoenfeld, explaining everything. I actually don't even know if I'll submit this. So it's a Beck's World and Dr. Schoenfeld combined thing, but I hope that I can continue to do everything that isn't bad for me, and keep progress going as much as I have the last couple of days. Going home helped tremendously because it put a lot of things in perspective. Definitely feel less hard on myself and less pressure, and just kind of like, you know, fuck it. You know, because I do really want to be successful in certain things, but also don't want to run myself into the ground or, you know, kill myself thinking about it instead of actually doing it. And I'm prone to doing both of those things. So, cheers with the Trump mug to new beginnings. This thing is so fucking funny. Also, Mary Lou's, sponsor me. All right. Good luck. Adios.